Fred.
The special delivery letter just came for you.
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome.
Don't you want to know what it's about? It looks important.
You've got the wrong merch. You're thinking about the Budinsky branch of the family. I'll go and tell Ethel to put on her earphones and stand by for a news flash.
Ricky! Ricky, special delivery!
Huh? Who is it from?
My mother. Now, Ricky, it must be important.
It can't be important to me. She doesn't even know I'm alive.
Oh, honey. She does, too. She always writes to both of us.
Yeah?
Sure.
Who's that letter addressed to?
Miss Lucy McGillicuddy. Well, honey, you know how mothers are. To Mama, I'll always be her little daughter, Lucy McGillicuddy. But she knows who I'm married to.
Yeah? Then why does she always write, Dear Lucy, how are you and how is what's his name?
Oh. Dear Lucy, how are you and how is Xavier?
Xavier?
Well, honey, she knows I'm married to a Latin American band leader. She just doesn't know which one.
Well, that's true. She's getting warmer all the time.
I love the pictures of the baby, and I'm relieved to see that he looks just like you.
Instead of Xavier.
Now, honey, the real reason I'm writing is because I went to my club meeting yesterday. You remember Flo Pauline Lopez, the club recording secretary. Well, it seems that Flo Pauline's old college roommate, Ella Scott Porter, has a cousin who married a man named Ford and went to live in a little town in Tennessee.
Wake me up when you get to the spicy stuff.
Well, it seems this cousin has a boy named Ernest. She has an older boy named George and a younger boy named Roger. Ernest is her middle boy. Well, to make a long story short...
It's too late.
To make a long story short, Ernest is on his way to New York, and I told Flo Pauline to tell Ella, to tell her cousin, to tell Ernest that you'd be glad to entertain him.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. She just got my interest.
Of course, I don't know Ernest personally, but any friend of Flo Pauline's roommate's cousin is a friend of mine. Love, Mother.
Now, look, you write to your mother right away, and you tell her that we're going out of town.
Oh, honey, she says he's on his way. There isn't time to write her.
Oh, great. Another visitor. Just what I needed. That makes three of them this month. What's the matter? Doesn't anybody ever stay home anymore?
Now, honey, it won't hurt us to be nice to him. After all, it's my mother's friend's roommate's cousin's middle boy.
Oh, I didn't realize that. That's different.
Well, now, honey, will you be nice to him?
Look, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll take him out to dinner once, and I'll have him down at the club as my guest. Once. And that's the end of it.
Well, that's fine. I think Mother will be very happy about that.
There you are. That's 12, 14, 15. 15 double.
L-U-C-K-E-L.
Luckle.
Luckle? That's not a word.
It is, too.
Well, I never heard of use it in a sentence.
Well, like, when you take a ride in a Fifth Avenue bus, you can either take the express or the local.
That is local.
That's what I say, local.
And for your information, it's spelled L-O-C-A-L. Now, take that back.
Wait till I get you in a high-ally game.
Oh, goodness.